हेलो चिल्ड्रन, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू न्यू चैप्टर, अ न्यू नेम. चैप्टर 4, अ न्यू नेम बाय लिंडा सोई पार्क. बिफोर आई स्टार्ट दिस चैप्टर, लेट्स नो अबाउट द राइटर. लिंडा सोई पार्क इज अ कोरियन अमेरिकन राइटर हु हैज़ ऑथर्ड सेवरल नॉवेल्स एंड पिक्चर बुक्स फॉर यंग एडल्ट एंड चिल्ड्रेन. मोस्ट ऑफ हर वर्क इज बेस्ड अपॉन कोरियन हिस्ट्री एंड कल्चर. In 2002, she wore the Newbery Medal for a single shirt. Student, let's start this chapter. Before I start, student, I want to tell you this is a story of a 10-year-old Korean girl whose name was Chains. Okay, and how she feel and how what she suffered. Let's see. Students, open page number 29, and please. Take pencil in your hand and put the pencil on the line which I will read. This is the story of a 10-year-old Korean girl, Kim Sun Hee, and her brother Kim Tae-yul. It is the year 1940 and the Japanese have taken over Korea. The Korean people are very unhappy. They do not have the freedom to learn their history, follow their culture or speak their language. Suddenly there comes a new law. All Koreans are to take Japanese names. The children's father knows that the law must be obeyed or else his family could face strict punishment. So he helps them choose Japanese name that reflect their Korean roots. Now Sun Hee must learn to accept her new name. How does she feel? Student, this is the story of a 10-year-old Korean girl whose name was Kim Sun Hee and her brother whose name was Kim Tae-yul. And this is a story about the year 1940 and the Japanese have taken over Korea. And the people of Korean are not happy. They were very unhappy. Why? Because they do not have the freedom to learn their history. They do not have the right to learn their history and follow their culture and even speak their languages. Even they do not have the right to learn their history, follow their culture, and even they do not have right to speak their language also. And then suddenly came a new law. And what's that new law? All the Koreans have to take the Japanese name. It means all the Koreans have to change their names. And the father of the children, they know that the law must be obeyed. Means the parents know that the law must be obeyed or his family could face a strict punishment. Means if they will not follow the rules, then they have to face a strict punishment. So the father of the Korean family, fathers of the Korean family, helps them to choose Japanese name, but that reflect the Korean roots. Means they will keep the Japanese name, but the names reflect the Korean roots. And now Sun Hee must have to learn to accept her new name. And how does she feel? How she suffered? Let's know. Students, paragraph 1. Students, para 1. Let's see. When my turn came, I pointed to the letter K. Abuji gave me a new name. And I went around whispering over and over, Kiko Kanema, Kiko Kanema. Students, Abuji means father. Okay, father in Korean languages, in Korean word we can say. Now, Sun Hee is saying that, Kim is saying that when her turn came, then she pointed a letter and that letter was K. And her father gave her a new name and she was whispering that name over and over. Means she was whispering her new name Why? Because she want to learn that name. She was repeating her name over and over. Why? Because she want to learn that name. And what's that name? Kiko. Kaneyama Kiko. Then she was whispering Kiko, Kaneyama Kiko, Kiko. And her Japanese name was Kaneyama Kiko. Second paragraph. Japanese family names are usually long like Kaneyama. Korean ones like my name Kim are short. Similarly, Korean first names are almost always two syllables, but Japanese first name can be long or short. Syllables means students, as you can, its meaning given in your book, parts of a word that contain single vowel sounds and are pronounced as a unit, means the parts of a word that contain a single vowel sound. Now she is saying that Japanese family names are usually long in comparison of Korean name, okay, like Kaneyama. Korean ones like my name Kim. As you can see, the Korean name Kim, it was very short, and the Japanese name Kaneyama is too long. And similarly, Korean first names are almost always two syllables, and she was saying that Korean name, the name of the first name of the Korean was very short. It may be of two syllables, but the Japanese first name can be long or short. We cannot say that it may be long or it may be short. Third paragraph. I like how Abuji had hidden our real last name in the new one he had chosen for us, and he had done the same for my first name as well. Girls' names often ended in ko, which means girl in Japanese, but ko could also mean the sun's rays. So Kiko meant rays of brightness, the same as my real name. And yet while I could accept Kaneyama Kiko as a name, I could not think of it as my name. She was saying that I liked how my father, as I've told you students, Abuji means father. I liked how my father had hidden my real name, hidden our real name in our new name. Okay. And he had chosen for us. Here we can say us means student. The Korean family name Kim means gold in Korea. It refers to a clan of people that lived in the mountains. With this in mind, the father chooses Kaneyama as their Japanese family name. Yama means mountain in Japanese and Kane means gold. Okay, now she's saying that father has hide her new old name into her new name, and had done the same for my first name as well also. Now she's saying that girls' names always often ended in ko, which means girl in the Japanese, but in Korean, ko means the sun's rays. Okay, but in Korean, ko means the sun's rays. So Kiko meant rays of brightness, the same as the real name. And yet while I could accept Kaneyama Kiko as a name, I could not think of it as my name. Now she's saying that I could accept my new name Kaneyama Kiko, but I could not think of it as my real name. She can't accept it. Student, this story is Kim Sun Hee is a Korean girl, but her Japanese name had to be Kaneyama Kiko, as I've told you, and she found it strange because the Japanese family name Kaneyama was long, unlike her Korean family name Kim, and she felt strange to be identified by a foreign name. Okay, and tried to get used to be Kaneyama Kiko by repeating the name softly to herself. That's why she was repeating her name over and over. And her Korean name Sun Hee and her Japanese name Kiko, both the meaning are same. Both are same in the meaning. And what's the meaning of this both name? Rays of brightness. That was cleverness of her father, as girl's name in Japanese usually ended in ko, which means girl, and her Korean family name Kim means gold, and the Japanese family name Kaneyama also carried the same meaning with Yama, meaning mountain, and Kaneyama means gold. and students she found it strange to be called by a different name as if she was given a new identity as a person. Paragraph 4. For the next few days there was a terrible confusion at school. We had to call our classmates only by their Japanese names. Suddenly the girl crossed Ashley from me was Megumi, not Megyongin, and the boy who sat behind me was Masato instead of young one. Ashley means a student. A long narrow space between rows of seats in room or in an aeroplane or train, or we can say a long narrow space between two rows of seats as you can see in your classroom. And for next few days what happened, there was a terrible confusion. Why? Because all the students have to call the Korean students name to into a Japanese name, means we had to call classmates only by their Japanese names. And suddenly there crossed a girl whose name was Megumi, not Myungin, and the boy who sat behind her was Masato instead of young one. Okay, means he want to say that there was a confusion in the classroom, means children found it difficult to remember the new Japanese names of their Korean classmates and also to remember to respond to your own Japanese name. Means now they were facing the problem. Students, next page. Our teacher tried to be patient with us if we forgot and use our classmates' real names. She prompted us gently at first, but more sternly as the days passed. Prompted means encouraged them to say their Japanese names. Now she is saying that her teacher was very patient and she tried to be patient with them. Why? Because they were the students and they were very small and they forgot to call their classmates' name classmate Japanese name. They forget and they call with their real names, with their Korean name. But the teacher prompted them, encouraged them, and gently at first, but earlier she encouraged them gently to call their Japanese name, but the time has passed, then sternly, very strictly she told them to call their Japanese name as the days pass. Paragraph 6. I was a young student. I had never once given the teacher cause to be beat me. I was very careful to use everyone's Japanese name and to respond when anyone said Kiko. Even though it felt as if they were talking to someone else. But the next day, my brain grew tired of being careful every single minute and it happened. Now she is saying that I was a very good student and I had never given a chance to my teacher to beat me. And I was very, she was saying, she was very careful to use everyone's Japanese name and she also very careful to respond when anyone called her Kiko. And she was very quick and active, we can say, and she is very careful to respond when anyone called with her Japanese name. And even though it feels as if they were talking to someone else, when they call them Kiko and talk with her, when they call her Kiko and talk with her, she feels that they were talking to someone else. But she was very careful to reply. But the next day, what she was saying, her brain grew very tired. Why? Because she has to be careful a single minute, or we can say a single second. She has to be very careful. That's why she felt very tired. And the things happened the same, means her brain was tired and she was also tired to remember and to be careful when anyone called her Kiko. Paragraph 7. I chose the worst possible moment to make a mistake. Onishi-san was in the room. He was a Japanese army officer whose job was to make sure all the students were learning to be good citizens of the empire. San means a student's respectful way to address someone in Japanese. Empire means it refers to the Japanese empire. Now what happened? A Japanese army officer whose name was Onesi San was on the round, and he was in the round in her classroom. On the same time, she made a mistake. As she told her, "I choose the worst possible moment to make a mistake." Means when she done a mistake, it was the worst time when she done a mistake. Why? Because the Japanese army officer Onesi San was there in the classroom, and his was the duty to make sure that all the students were learning to be good citizen. Means all the students were taking their classmates' name, Japanese name, and they were following all the rules of the empire or not. Paragraph 8. He came into our classroom several times a week, often in the middle of a lesson. We always stopped what we were doing and bowed to him. He would stand at the back of the room and observe us for a while. I could tell he made the teacher nervous, and I tried especially hard to give the right answers when he was around. Now she was saying that officer came into their classroom several times in a week, and they have to stop in the middle. They have to stop their study in the middle of the lesson, and they always stop them, and they have to board in front of them like this. Okay, in front of him, sorry, and they have to board in front of him, and they had to stand at the back of the room. Is the officer stand at the back of the room and watch them, inspect them, that they were doing their work properly or not. Means that officer observed them. And I could tell he made the teacher nervous. Means when he came into the classroom, the teacher also become very nervous. He also felt very nervous. But the Kiko tried very hard to give the right answer, not to make any mistake when he was around. Paragraph 9. That day I knew he was in the room. I knew I had to be extra careful not to make mistake, and somehow I did the very thing I was trying so hard not to do. I said Myungin instead of Megumi. Now she is saying that I tried very hard to not to do any mistake. She was very careful to not make any mistake when he was in the classroom. But she made a mistake. She was trying so hard not to do, but she told what? She said Myungin instead of Megumi. She pronunciated the name wrong. She pronunciated anyone to the Korean name, but she has to pronunciate the Japanese name, but she has done the mistake. Paragraph 10. Onesi-san heard me. He made a funny sound in his throat like a. Then he looked at the teacher and made an interrupt motion with his stick. Interrupt means student, sudden and unexpected. When Onesi-san heard this, then he made a funny sound voice. He made a sound in his throat. The sound was a. And then he looked at the teacher and stopped the motion with his stick by using his stick. Next, the teacher glanced at him quickly and then at me. Kiko to the front, she said. The teacher was very surprised and she glanced at him quickly. She stared at him quickly and then she looked at the Kiko to the front, she said. And she said to the Kiko to the front. Now she can't do anything. The teacher can't do anything. She can't. Why? Because that officer was in the classroom. As I've told you, student, when they made mistake, when the student made mistake, when they do not, when they call their classmates' name to their old name, then the teacher encouraged them, but the teacher did not beat them. Okay. But now the officer was in the classroom. So she has to do something. 12. The class was suddenly silent. I could see the surprise in the faces of the other students. After all, I was the daughter of the vice principal and I never been beaten before. Students, now was Kiko was the daughter of the vice principal. She was the daughter of the vice principal, and when teacher told her to stand in the front, then the class was totally silent. Every was very surprised, and in the faces, matlab everyone can see the surprise. We can see the surprise faces of the students. Why? Because she was the daughter of the vice principal, and even she never made any mistake also, and she never been beaten also before. Never she beaten before. 13th paragraph. In the brief moments it took me to walk to the front of the class, I saw the teacher's face. She looked so unhappy that I felt sorrier for her than for myself. She didn't want to beat me, but she had to because Onishi-san was there. In the brief moments it took me to walk to the front of the class. It was take a brief moment that she walked to the front of the class as the teacher has told her, and I saw teacher's face. She looked so unhappy. The teacher was also very sad. Why? Because she don't want to beat her. Why? Because Kiko was a very good student and she never made any mistake. And Kiko felt very sorrier. Sorrier means weekend students. You're sad. Okay. Kiko felt very sad for teacher and for herself also, because she had made a mistake in front of the officer. And the teacher didn't want to beat her, but she had to beat because the officer was there. That's why she has to beat her. Paragraph 14. It was so unfair. First our names were taken away, and then we weren't given any time to learn each other's new names. Now the Kiko was saying that it was really unfair. Why? Because firstly, they Japanese have taken their name. They have to keep new name. And even they didn't get a time to learn their new names. Okay. Firstly, they have to change their name, and they didn't get time to learn their name also. And it was really a very bad thing, very unfair thing had happened with them. Students, till paragraph 14, I have explained. In next video, I have explained from paragraph 15. Thank you.